In this video, you'll learn how to use Revolve, Fillet, Extrude, and Circular Pattern features. So open your Fusion and let's go. The first step to create this part, we'll select the front plane and make this sketch, okay? Here will be our midpoint. The first thing that we make, we'll create this line here. The distance between this point and the midpoint is 174/2. So open the Fusion, go to create a sketch, select the front plane, select a line, make a line here, go to sketch dimension. The distance between these two points here is 174/2. Press OK. And the distance between this point here and the midpoint is 240 mm/2. So go to sketch dimension, 240 mm/2. Press OK. Go to constraint, select horizontal vertical, select this point and this point here. We made this. Now let's create this construction line here with 116 mm. So select line, construction line, click here at the midpoint, 116 mm. Okay. Now here, let's create this line here and this one. Okay. So select line, click here at this point, remove the construction line type, make two lines here. Okay. And the distance between this point here and this point is 66.8 mm. And the angle between this line and the construction line is 45 degrees. Okay. So go to sketch dimension. The angle here is 45 degrees. And the distance between this point here and this point here is 66.8 mm. Okay, we made this. Now let's create this line here and make two lines here. Okay, we'll put the dimensions later. Select the line, click here at this line at this point. Make this sketch here, go to constraint, select horizontal vertical, select this point here and this point here. Okay, to put this here, horizontal constraints. Okay, and the distance between this point here and the construction line here, the midpoint, is 50 mm/2. Okay, 25 mm, so go to sketch dimension. The distance here is 25 mm. And the distance between this point here and the midpoint is 40 mm, is 8 mm/2. Okay. So select this point and select this point here. The distance here is 40 mm. Okay. And here, let me move this a little bit. Now let's create a line here with 8 mm. So select line, make a line here with 8 mm. Okay. And here the distance, the thickness here is 160 mm, this distance, minus 8 mm, so it will be minus 8 mm. It will be 108 mm. Okay, and we know that the distance here is 105, so 108 minus 105 mm, okay, equal 3. So here, select the sketch dimension, the distance between this line and this point here is 3 millimeters. Okay, select the line, make a line here. The thickness here is 3 millimeters. Okay, go to sketch dimension, the distance here, go to constraint and select parallel, select this line and this line, this line and this one, go to sketch dimension, the distance here is 3 millimeters and the distance here, sorry, the distance between these two lines here is 3 millimeters. Okay, now we have to make this line here with 8 millimeters and close the sketch here. Okay, so select a line, click at this point, make a line here with 8 millimeters and close the sketch here. Go to constraint, select coincident, select this point here. We made this, okay? Let me move the dimensions here a little bit. Okay, we made this. So, finish the sketch. Go to Revolve Features, select this profile. The axis is this construction line, the angle 360 degrees, and press OK. We made this. Okay. Now here we have a chamfer here with 4 millimeters by 45 degrees. So go to modify, select the chamfer, select this face here, this edge, sorry. The distance here is 4 millimeters. 4 millimeters by 4 millimeters, okay. The type here, echo distance, press OK. Now let's make the fillet. We have a fillet here with 6 millimeters of radius. So go to modify, select fillet, select this edge here. The fillet here is 6 millimeters. Add selection set. We have another fillet here with 6 millimeters. In the both sides, in the outside, in the intern here, the in the inside. So select this edge here, rotate this, select this inside edge here, 6 millimeters. Okay, we made this. Add selection set. We have a fillet here with 4 millimeters of radius. Okay, in the both sides, in this side here and inside. So select this edge here, rotate this, select it inside here, 4 millimeters. We made this. Now here we have a fillet here with 2 millimeters of radius, and we have a fillet here with 2 millimeters of radius. Okay, so add selection set. Select this edge here. Sorry. Add selection set. Select this edge and this edge, 2 millimeters. And press OK. We made this. Okay. Now we need to create this cut here. So to create this cut, we'll select the top plane. Oh, the top face here to make a sketch. So go to create a sketch, select this face here. We have this. Go to create, select the project include, project. And here, select this face here and press OK. We can hide this body a little bit. We have this. Now here in the top plane, we'll create this arc here, this circle with 123 millimeters of diameter. So select the circle, select the construction line, click here at the midpoint, make a circle here with 123 millimeters of diameter. Okay. And here, we need to create this tool a construction line here first. Okay. Select the line, construction line, click at this point to this point here. And here we need to create this sketch here. We know that this base here has 20 millimeters. And the angle between these two lines here, okay, is the same here, is 7 degrees, the angle between this edge and the construction line. So here, select line, remove the construction line type. Make a line here, make this sketch here, okay? Make sure that this line here is coincident with this construction line. Go to sketch dimension. The distance here is 20 millimeters. The distance between this point and this line here is 10 millimeters. Let me move this a little bit. The angle between this line here and this construction line is 7 degrees. And the angle here is 7 degrees. Let me move the dimensions here. We made this. Now go to constraints and select coincident. Select this line and this point here. Okay. And here go to modify, select break. Select this part here and this part here. Now select these two parts and remove the construction line type. And we have this profile. Okay. To make a cut here. So finish the sketch. Show the body one. Go to extrude, select all this profile here, okay? We need to make a cut here, and this cut will be from this top face to this line here, so will be 116 millimeters to this side minus 38, okay? So let's make this. So move this a little bit to this side. So here will be minus 116 plus 38. Operation cut, press OK. We made this, okay? Now we needed to use the circular pattern to create the other cut, which will be 18 cuts. So go to create, select pattern, circular pattern, okay? The object type, select features. The object, select this cut. The axis, click here in this face. And the quantity here is 18, press OK. We made this, okay? Now to finish this exercise, we need to make these holes here. We have 18 holes here, okay? And the diameter of this hole is 12 millimeters. So go to create sketch, select this space here. And select a circle. Make a circle here with 12 millimeters of diameter. Okay. The distance here, let's check the distance between this edge here and this edge here, which will be in the center of this. So the distance here is 24 millimeters. Select a circle, select a construction line type, make a circle here. Okay, go to sketch dimension. The distance between this circle and this one, it will be 12 millimeters. So it will be in the... It will be between this edge and this edge here, okay? And go to constraint, select coincident, select this circle and this one, and go to constraint again, select horizontal vertical, select this point and this point here, okay? Finish the sketch. Go to extrude, select this profile. The operation here is cut. The extended type, select all, Maybe you need to flip this and press OK. Now go to circular pattern again, the object type, select the features, the object, select this cut here, and the axis, select this edge here, the quantity is 18, and press OK. And here we finish our exercise. So thanks for watching, subscribe my channel for more, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.